still plan on doing worship online. So for those of you that have been viewing online, there won't be any changes. We'll still continue to do as we have done. But for those of you that do intend to come to in-person worship, it will be 9 o'clock at Dexter and 10:30 at Grand Rapids. So that will be next Sunday. And for Dexter, we have, with the realities of COVID, had to kind of change the way in which we do communion. So it is Communion Sunday. If you would, it would be appreciated that you would bring your own elements to use for the communion portion of the service. So please keep that in mind. Otherwise, it's going to be, I think, pretty much regularly scheduled activities with confirmation. And we are moving for Dexter our administrative council meeting to Thursday instead of Wednesday. So we've been doing that now because of confirmation. So just keep all those things in mind. It's a beautiful day that God has given us, and I'm so glad that all of us can have the opportunity to worship together. We begin with the call to worship. Praise God who loves us all.
Praise God who is full of mercy and compassion.
Praise God who loves us well.
Praise God who creates honesty and justice.
Praise God who invites us to love.
Praise God who loves through us and our actions. Amen.
We've always said that our recording of these services is a work in progress, and I guess last week the sound quality wasn't quite what maybe we hoped, so I tried to adjust the mic a little bit, and we'll see, and you know, keep giving us some feedback, because we always appreciate people letting us know how things are going and what kind of quality had, especially with sound. So hopefully again today will be a little bit better, and we'll just keep working at it. So, like I say, we need you to tell us, because otherwise I don't, and everybody else doesn't know. So, like I say, positive feedback and help is always encouraged. Otherwise, there's a prayer request shared for Bonnie and Joy from Pat Grace, and they have some health concerns, and so we're going to remember them in our prayer time. And I believe that Dixie and Lawrence Jeck had a very special wedding anniversary, and you might have saw a clown here in town that helped celebrate that, so congratulate them. Let's join in our opening prayer. Loving God, love through us as we worship your holy name. Love through us as we listen for your holy word. Love through us as we live through your teachings and offer your love to our world. In your majestic name we pray. Amen. Let's go to the Lord now in the spirit of reflection. Lord, we thank you now for the opportunity to worship. We thank you now for the opportunity to see your grace at work in our lives. We especially want to pray for Bonnie and Joy and for others who have health concerns and needs, that doctors, caregivers bring healing. We pray for an end to the pandemic. We pray that vaccine will be effectively distributed. And again, just may your grace find a way to shine through to bring healing and hope to us and to those around us. Help us now to live as your people. Fill us with your love and fill us with your grace. As we pray now that prayer that you have taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, what I have to show this morning is not exactly what I wanted. It was about the closest I could get to what I wanted. So I'll ask a question before I can show you this. But as far as the kids, you don't get the opportunity yet to drive, but you might get in a car. Have you ever been on a slippery road and realized that you were going to be heading towards the ditch?
Yes.
That is probably one of the most helpless feelings in the world. And I don't know, it seems to me like when that happens, you feel like you're in slow motion. And you can't do anything about it. And then you realize, most likely, oh, I'm stuck. And how does it feel to be stuck? Not good. So this is the closest I could come to a tow truck. Because if you're stuck, you gotta get somebody to get you out. And sometimes in life, we get stuck. And that's the wonderful thing about Jesus is that he has the ability to get us unstuck. So let's pray. Lord, we just thank you that when we're stuck and things aren't going right, you're there to help us, to encourage, to bless us, to get us unstuck as we offer this prayer in your name. Amen. We continue to encourage you to send your gifts to the church and to our financial secretaries for each congregation, Diane O'Connor at Dexter and Donna Cerise at Grand Meadow. This is the call to offering. As actions of grace and love, let us offer our gifts and lives to God. Give freely and genuinely from the heart. Please join with me now in our offering prayer. Holy, awesome God, we bring our gifts of paper and coin, symbols of our gratitude and love. Bless these symbols that they may be our acts of love and grace. Bless us and our gifts that we may transform the world with love and grace. In gratitude and hope we pray. Amen. And today I read from the first chapter of the Gospel of Mark, verses 21 through 28. This is where Jesus cries out of the impure spirit. They went to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach. The people were amazed at his teaching because he taught them as one who had authority and not as the teachers of the law. Just then a man in their synagogue who was possessed by an impure spirit cried out, "What do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." "Be quiet," said Jesus sternly. "Come out of him." The impure spirit shook the man violently and came out of him with a shriek. The people were also amazed that they asked each other, "What is this? A new teaching and with authority?" He even gave orders to the impure spirits and they obey him. News about him spread quickly over the whole region of Galilee. One of my friends from when I was going to school and seminary in Kentucky was named Mike. And I think Mike is still a pastor somewhere in Ohio. I kind of lost touch with him a few years back, but anyways, it was very interesting to listen to Mike talk about his life. You know, everybody has kind of a story and different things, and talks about the reason, you know, that would bring them, you know, to seminary to become a pastor. And you say, yeah, I know, but you have to realize that this is a God thing. And it was God that got me here and where I am now. And it's not going to be that way for everybody. You know, a lot of people need 12-step programs. They need all kinds of things to help them. But God sets people free. And that's the point. And you look at this passage of Scripture today, and, you know, basically Jesus is beginning his ministry. And in Mark's Gospel, it happens in a pretty dramatic fashion. You know, Jesus, on the Sabbath, is teaching in the synagogue. And there's this man that approaches him, and the man, you know, says to him, what do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know you are the Holy One of God. He has an impure spirit, and whatever that is, you know, we don't know for sure. We know that here's somebody that's hurting. Here is somebody that's terribly troubled, somebody who is struggling. And what does Jesus do? He says, be silent, come out of him. Jesus sets him free. And he casts out that impure spirit. And that's, I think, really a lot of what this is that basically that is what Christ has come into this world to do. It's to set people free, to give them life, to give them joy, and all the things that he wants to share with them. And he did that as he took this impure spirit and he removed it from this man in the synagogue. I was reading the story of, this first name is Mike, and I can't pronounce his last name very well, but it was kind of interesting because basically his college football coach said, what I'd like you all to do is consider being donors for bone marrow. And he said, more than likely, told all the team, you will never be called. You know, all you need to do is put your name on a list, and more than likely, you won't have anybody call you. But if you are called, this could really be a situation where you can make a big difference. And so Mike thought, well, why not? You know, yeah, just go in and sign up, and it ain't a big deal. Well, it wasn't that long afterwards Mike was called. And he said, okay, you know, I don't know anything about this person because the way it usually works is they don't give you any information. They just say there's a need. Are you willing to be a donor? And he said, okay, I'll come in and, you know, we'll do all the tests and stuff and everything that we need to do, and I will be willing to participate in whatever this need is. So he went in, he did his part. But flash forward, the person that was going to receive his bone marrow transplant was a little girl named Eleanor, just a few months old. And basically, Eleanor's situation was is that she did not get a bone marrow transplant. She was not going to have probably much of a so after that, you know, again, there was just a lot of contact back and forth. And it turned out that, you know, basically it was like, you know, Mike became a part of Eleanor's family. And Eleanor's mom would say, you know, it's really wonderful to see that somebody that was a stranger could turn out basically loving your child almost as much as you. And all that came from just being willing to sign a piece of paper saying, yeah, I'm willing to be a donor. You know, it's kind of interesting, you know, things are challenging for people right now. People are struggling, people are hurting, it's tough. You know, with all the things that are going on. And it doesn't need to be, you know, really dramatic kinds of things. A lot of times, you know, it might be if somebody's down, just coming up alongside saying to somebody that's hurting, you know, I maybe had something similar in my life that was a struggle, and I got through it, and I think you can do this. I think you can make it. You can get through this. And that's the kind of stuff that sets people free. It's interesting because Jesus said to his disciples, his followers, you know, I'm giving you the authority to cast out demons. You know, be silent. Come out of here. And I think that we, as Christ's people and the church, that's what we're here to do. We're here to set people free. So let's pray. Lord, as that man came to you, it was obvious the pain and the hurt and all the struggle that he was going through. And he cried out, and he just said to the demons and all the brokenness that was inside of him, be silent, come out of him. And as we look at our world, there is so much, again, that is challenging right now. And people are suffering, people are hurting. But you give us the opportunity as the church to work with you in helping set people free and to give them new life, new opportunities, to bring healing as we offer this prayer in your name. want to thank you for joining